Start.
Today we will study and verify the gyroscopic principle. For that, first we will study the theory behind gyroscopic principle. What is gyroscope first? So this is gyroscope. It consists of rotating rotor, inner gimbal and outer gimbal, which is not over here for the modification of setup. Because of this arrangement, it has 3 degrees of freedom. First is spinning about x axis, rotation about z axis and precession about vertical axis, that is y axis. Means it has 3 degrees of freedom. First is spinning about x axis, tilting about z axis and precession about vertical axis. Because of this 3 degrees of freedom, we will get a unique gyroscopic principle that when we start this setup with the help of motor and when rotor is spinning about x axis already and when a mass or external mass or couple is applied on this gyroscope, instead of falling down like this, right now it is falling down due to application of load, but when the rotor starts spinning about x axis and when we apply external load or couple, instead of falling down, it starts presses in a perpendicular plane or about a perpendicular axis. This unique principle is known as gyroscopic principle. This gyroscopic principle has wide application in aeroplane, while steering a ship in water, when we drive two-wheeler and when we are taking a turn along a curved path. To balance that, to counteract the active gyroscopic couple, we tilt vehicle by some angle. It is actually application of reactive gyroscopic couple. So as I said, when external load is applied during the rotor is spinning about x-axis, instead of falling down due to external mass, it presses in a perpendicular plane about a vertical axis. This is known as gyroscopic principle. So earlier we have studied what is the gyroscopic experimental setup. Now we will study how to calculate the magnitude of gyroscopic couple. The gyroscopic couple magnitude is calculated by R into omega into omega b, where C is the gyroscopic couple, I is the mass moment of inertia of rotor. So that is calculated by M into K square, where M is the mass of rotor, it is given 6.3 kg. K is the radius of gyration of rotor, which is R by root 2, and where R is 0.15. So with the help of observation given, we can calculate mass moment of inertia of rotor. Then omega, as I have written over here, it's an angular velocity. Omega is equal to 2 pi n by 60. This n is the RPM of rotor. We can calculate it with the help of tachometer. Then omega p, as I said, that when external force is applied, instead of falling down, it presses, means it rotates about a vertical plane. This precession, angular velocity of precession, is very important. And in our setup, we will calculate by omega p, means angular velocity of precession, we will calculate by theta by t. Theta means we will assume some angle, let's say 50 or 70 degree. How much time is required to cover that much angle? It is theta by t. Means suppose for 50 degree, how much time is required? Let's say 70 degree, how much time is required? With the help of this, we will calculate omega. We will take the reading of gyroscopic couple for three different masses. First reading will be for 1 kg, second will be for 1.5 kg and third will be for 2 kg. According to gyroscopic principle, as soon as we apply the mass, instead of falling down, it will precess about a perpendicular axis. So, earlier we have studied the theory behind gyroscopic principle and the formula, gyroscopic couple is equal to I into omega p. Now we actually calculate the gyroscopic principle. For that, this setup is run with the help of motor, and speed will be varied by dimmer stat. Now first we will measure the RPM with the help of tachometer, and we have measured already, it is about 1600 RPM. Then let's say we have to calculate the precessional angular velocity. For that we should know the angle theta. Let's say for 60 degree. So for 60 degree, how much time is required to overcome this? Here a circular reading is given. So now mass is applied. Now you can see when external mass is applied, instead of falling down, it is precessing about a vertical axis. So we will note down the time required to cover a 60 degree angle, and then we will do the calculation. So this is observation table. We have taken reading for 1 kg. We have measured the RPM of rotor with the help of tachometer. For 60 degree, we have converted it into radian by multiplying pi by 180, and it was also required to cover this 60 degree, around 6.77 second is required. So with the help of this, we will calculate theoretical couple. I is, as I said, mass moment of inertia, m into k square. Omega will be RPM converted into 2 pi m by 60, and omega p will be theta by t, and m into k square. So with the help of this, we will calculate the theoretical gyroscopic couple. Now to verify this theoretical gyroscopic couple, experimentally we will measure experimental gyroscopic couple. As we have applied external mass, let's say 1 kg, correct? 1 kg is applied into distance of mass applied from the center of the rotor. L is the distance of from mass applied to the center of rotor. So it means what? External mass, let's say 1 kg into 9.81 into that L, means force into perpendicular distance, we will get couple. That answer will be in Newton meter, and this theoretical couple will be also in Newton meter. So we will verify the theoretical gyroscopic couple with experimental gyroscopic couple. So in this way we have verified the gyroscopic couple experimentally and theoretically, and we have verified it successfully. So why we studied this gyroscopic principle verification experiment? It is because you are using this gyroscopic couple application in your daily life. While driving two-wheeler, when you take a turn along a curved path, the wheels of two-wheeler and engine rotor is already spinning along its axis. But when two-wheeler tries to take turn, it tries to take turn about a vertical axis. So because of that, active gyroscopic couple acts in a one direction. So to counteract that, rider tilts vehicle by some angle. So that reactive gyroscopic principle will be acted, and two-wheeler will take turn without skidding. This is the application of gyroscopic couple. Thank you very much for watching. This is Professor Sakshi Shah from Mechanical Engineering Department, TSSM, Bhiwara Bhai Sawant, College of Engineering, Narepuri.